What's going on, guys? We're here today. I'll be doing my first ever Subway line review. So in my channel bio, I did say a while ago that I would start doing these. But, you know, I just never got around to it. You know, school got in the way. I was getting into a lot of drama. My mental health wasn't the best. But, you know, as I'm starting to get into swing of things, I'm going to be doing Subway train reviews. Yeah, I'm being Subway car reviews, Subway line reviews, and today's review, we will be doing the IRT 7th Avenue Broadway line. So, without further ado, let's roll the intro. So the IRT 7th Avenue Broadway line starts at South Ferry. Hey, yo, not that South Ferry. South Ferry Loop. That's for all the cultured swines out there that think new South Ferry is actually good. I mean, it's good for something, but you know what I mean. Anyway, from there it heads up to Chamber Street, where after a quick flyover junction, it meets up with the 2 and 3. While the 2 and 3 go 69 miles per hour on the express track, the one train is left on the local track. This continues until 96th Street. After there, the 2 and 3 branch off once again to go on the IRT Lennox Avenue line, while the one train continues up by itself, lonely. It continues in this pattern until Dyckman Street, where it goes above ground, and continues being above ground, and then terminates at Van Cortlandt Park, 142nd Street. So, I don't really have much negativity to say about this line, honestly. The equipment it uses is the R62A is for the one train, the R62 is for the three train, and the R142 is for the two train. I mean, kind of bland, but hey, they handle it. They know how to handle that, let's be honest. They know how to handle that. So, honestly, IRT 7th Avenue Broadway line, amazing. The only thing that I don't like about it, though, is the designated announcements. Like, just listen to those announcements. Like,
this is a Brooklyn-bound 3 train. The next stop is 145th Street.
Now for some improvements I have. So you know how most of the line above 96th Street has a third track, right? Well, I think that we should revive the 9 train, make it go local from South Ferry 96th, and then, you know, it can run express via that third track, and then go weekday peak direction express, or whatever you call it. And you know, it could do that all in the daytime, and at night, it just doesn't exist. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. So now, I'm gonna pass it over to the NYCT channel.
Yo, what's up, guys? And if you don't know me, I'm the NYC Transit channel or the NYC Subway channel. Call me anything you want. It doesn't matter. But, you know, I'm talking about the 7th Avenue line on the IRT. So, you know, 1, 2, and 3 trains. The 9 train is nothing. Don't talk about the 9 train. But the 1, 2, and 3 trains. Okay, what do I like about the 1, 2, or 3 trains? Well, the 1 train, I like the 1 train because, I mean, okay, is the 1 train a good train? Is the 1 train a good train? In my opinion, it is. I mean, it's its own line. It goes to where it needs to go. It's not like it's a copy of that train, Z train. And you know, it's its own train. You can tell it's its own line, and many riders use it. It's the one local line. The only thing I don't like about it is that it goes to only two boroughs. It goes to literally only two boroughs, And Bronx is like 3 stops from the Bronx. So that's, I don't know about that. But everything else is okay. I think the one train, it goes to where it needs to go. Very popular lines, very popular stations on this on 7th Avenue. Now, the 2 train is different, but it is also the same amount of good. The 2 train is a very good line. It's by far the best IRT 7th Avenue Broadway line of the bunch. Obviously, you guys all know that. But this is why, okay? The 2 train goes to 3 boroughs. The 2 goes to literally 3 old boroughs. And those 3 boroughs, it goes to the stops that commuters love. For example, commuters. So, like, let's say Brooklyn, right? Brooklyn, we got Crown Heights, I believe. You got stuff like that. Atlantic Avenue. All those stations. And you would say, I'm going the 2 train to go to this particular stop. For rail fanners and for commuters, people love the 2 train in Brooklyn. Manhattan, the exact same thing. It's express or goes to every express and more popular lines of popular stations in Manhattan. And the Bronx, and the same with the Bronx. I think the 2 train is local in the Bronx. Either way, the 2 goes to every stop that commuters would love to go to in the Bronx as well. And that's why I say that the 2 train is a very good line. Better than the 1 line, way better. So, you know, I wouldn't even compare the 2 train to the A train. I ain't gonna lie, I really would. It's not the best line, not the best train ever, not my favorite line, but, you know, I really appreciate the 2 train a lot. And, you know, I would count it as one of the best lines in the MTA. The 3 train, however, is different, okay? The 3 train goes local in Brooklyn by itself until it when it matches up with the 4 train in Crown Heights, Utica Avenue, and then it kind of intersects with the 2 and 5 train in Franklin Avenue, and then it kind of goes where it needs to go. In Manhattan, it goes express with the 2 train, and the 1 train takes the local route until it goes uptown, where the 3 train kind of does where it needs to do. Then it stops at Harlem by itself. The 2 goes up to Bronx, where the 3 stays in Manhattan like a loner he is. Is the 3 train a good train? The 3 train is a very good train, but can I compare it to the 2 train? Absolutely not. Can I compare it with the 1 train? No, I cannot either. The 3 is not as bad as the 1 train. The 1 train is a really good train, but the 3 is not as bad as the 1 train and not as good as the 2 train. The 3 is in the middle. I'm not saying the 1 train is horrible. The 1 train is a very good train, but the 3 train is better than it. The 2 is better than the 3 train, though. So the worst to best should be 1-3-2, because that's kind of like the worst to best, kind of. I'm going to say like that. The 3 is an okay train. My opinion, only my opinion, I honestly don't like the area in Brooklyn, but that's only me. But the 3 goes places that commuters love to go to, and that's what I love about the 3 train. The 3 is a very good train, and yeah. So anyway, guys, I am sorry if I made this a little too long. I was trying to go as fast as I possibly can. I'm sorry, Dynamite. But, you know, if you want to, only if you want to, you can kind of, you know, search for my little channel if you want, you know. But, you know, subscribe to Dynamite. Also, he's the one who asked me to do this video. And very cool review from his part. So, yeah, thank him for all that stuff. And I'll see you guys. I don't even know. All right, peace out.
Alright guys, so that's the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed my first ever train review. If you do, tell me in the comments. Go ahead, like this video. Be sure to subscribe. We're on the road to 2,000. Go ahead, check out the NYC Subway Channel's channel. Keep in mind, that's just his opinion, alright? Do not go hating in the comments, alright? That's literally just his opinion. If you disagree with it, you can go take yourself elsewhere, okay? So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to like, subscribe, do it or else third rail. And I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. Bye.